in criteria A, focus and method, which is 6 marks and which is very, very important, I am dividing it into 3 sections. First is choice of topic, then research question, and then method and source is utilized. Topic should be a challenge for the student using the knowledge gained in physics course to answer the research question that goes beyond the course content. But at the same time, students should avoid broad or complex topics which are beyond the scope of action essay to answer in 4,000 words, such as investigations into quantum computers or black holes. Then another section is research question. The selection of research question is very, very important step of the student's investigation. And here, I would like that supervisor should play an important role that whether the student's choice of RQ is proper, is it realistic, is it promising, is it relevant or not. The student should define a narrow and well-focused question. And at this stage only, it is important to imagine what will be the possible outcomes and conclusion. Like, student should think of hypothesis. Doing so will help student in the process of defining the question and choosing proper methodology. Also, remember that the research question must be expressed as a question, not a statement. It must be expressed clearly and precisely. And it should also appear early in the introduction of the essay as well as on the title page. See this research question, how clear and precise it is, like how does a varying tuning fork resonant frequency affect the angular motion of a ping pong ball in a pendulum? So there are variables, independent variable, dependent variable, clearly mentioned in the RQ. Another section in criteria A is methods of approach. So student can choose to answer their research question with an essay which is solely based on theory, or it is a mix of both theory and the collection of data. Now, collection of data can be primary data or use of secondary data. So let's look into, if it is a primary data, what are the key pointers that student need to take care and supervisor need to guide the student accordingly. I'll say that student should choose experiments that do not require extensive length of time for construction of the apparatus. Because there is a misconception with some students that if they will be using highly sophisticated instruments, which are a rare requirement, right, it can hinder the understanding of a phenomena because it will take the major time of the extended essay. And then sometimes student is tempted to write a detailed description of those instruments and the detailed procedure. So that is not required. In fact, some of the best extended essay have been written by students investigating relatively simple phenomena using school apparatus, and this approach should be encouraged by the supervisors. Student must give a clear and concise description of their experimental procedure, no doubt, and the scientific diagrams needs to be annotated, but the exhaustive list of equipment and detailed description of procedures should be avoided. Many times then examiner will write that it is like a cookbook recipe. If the student is using secondary data, then student should consider the reliability as the student is considering for primary data. And student should critically evaluate the secondary data and the design of the experiment through which that secondary data is collected. Because student will manipulate or analyze the secondary data in the original way. If it is simply a restatement of the facts or the data collected, then it is not having much importance. So, what are the key pointers that supervisor need to bring the attention of the student? First of all, title. The title of the essay should reflect the essence of the investigation. As I mentioned earlier, it is very, very important. Title itself can clearly describe what is the topic or what is the aim of the essay. But at the same time, topic should not be too long. And if required, it can be clarified early in the essay, maybe in the introduction. Okay, next is introduction. Now, it is advisable to write introduction as a separate labeled section, and student need to write introduction in the beginning of the action essay, but it is highly recommended that student need to revisit the introduction and keep modifying as and when the research is progressing. So what to include in the introduction? I'll say research question, context, worthiness, methodological approach. According to me, what research questions are good? If it is narrowed down, focused, and it can be covered in 4,000 words. But if the research question is confused, if it is interdisciplinary, not relevant to the subject, dominated by some other subject, or if unfeasible to research, as it carries little or no degree to research, then it is not a good research question. Supervisors need to take care that student is not doing duplication of work, means extended essay is not submitted as part of any other assessment. It is not double barrel, means RQ having two different questions, two different theories are compared, then it is okay. But if they are completely two different questions, so that is double barrel, that is not a good idea. Then double dipping. What happens that student is doing IA and then student is thinking that let's extend this IA and make it more rigorous so it will be converted into extended essay. So that should not be the case. As a supervisor, you need to look into it that it should allow to collect sufficient data points and trials. I have seen that many times a potential research question is getting very less grades because that extended essay has lot of scope of collecting data, but student has not collected the data or the sufficient number of trials, or there is no scope of collecting data. So these things need to be taken care of. If it is source based approach, then definitely look into wide range of sources. Usually, I have seen that sources are relevant and appropriate, but you need to take care that there is a wide range of sources. And raw data must be present in the core of the essay, as appendix is not a part of the assessment. Please avoid these things in the introduction. Biographical data, political or religious stance, personal pronouns needs to be avoided. If a student is choosing physics as a subject for extended essay, so he or she should be able to answer RQ through focused evidence-based reason argument. And this evidence may be drawn from the student's personal experimentation, a book, or internet-based source. But the student must use principles of physics, and student should be able to fully explain by applying physics principle to their RQ. So the reader is convinced that student is having a genuine grasp of the physics involved.